Hello and welcome to round 2 of the World Super GT500 from the Red Bull Ring. I'm Josh Shotor and pretty soon I'll be joined by Joshua Anderson and the new guy, Casper Moss. But unfortunately, the beginning part of the audio was missing for some reason. So I've decided that, you know what, I might as well do it solo for this first bit. So we're here at the Red Bull Ring, a fantastic venue, and it is a great place to be for round 2. It's a lot of tight corners, very fast straights as well, and should be a great test for the drivers. So, that is a brief description of the track. We'll be using the soft and the medium tyres for this race. So there you go, that is a brief description of the Red Bull Ring. So let's have a look at the lap of this magnificent track. This is a lap of the Red Bull Ring here in Austria. So coming down the start-finish straight in fourth gear now, and we're going to start the lap now. Now up the hill towards turn one. This is a very tricky corner, breaking down into second gear, and then the car does get loose on the exit, but you can easily correct it. It's very normal to lose the back end. Now down this long straight, heading up towards the Remus curb through this little left-hander, and now we're at the Remus curb. Breaking just at the middle of that extra tarmac that's on the left, then getting it around the corner. You don't have to take the curb because at the end of the day, you can still gain a lot of time out of the corner. Now down this long straight, which is also used for a DRS straight in Formula 1, but of course there are no DRS on these GT cars. Now, brake just at the bridge and breaking for this right-hander. The car goes go unsettled, and you can easily understeer into the gravel through here. Now through this fast right-hander now, and now braking through these double left-handers, braking down just at the beginning of this left-hander. Now, you don't have to take the curb, and don't use the outside there, because otherwise you're going to lose time. Braking very hard for this left-hander now, and then get on the curb on the right, or take a bit of it if you want. Now, up the hill towards this tiny straight, and into the last two corners. This is a very tricky part of the track. It's easy to understeer and go wide. Brake at the 50-meter board, taking the curb on the outside, and braking just before the end of that curb, and going around the last corner, and that is a lap of the Red Bull Ring. So, that is a lap of the track, so let's have a look at the grid then. It's James Willows on pole position with Matthew Tatani, his teammate, in second place. So two Willows Nissan Grand Prix cars locking out the front row. Then two Lexuses are locking out the second row, with Matthew Redmore third and James Head in fourth. Matt Orange is in fifth, with Wace Cuba in sixth. Sean Grant is seventh, with Oliver Glazebrook in eighth position. Robert Hunter is ninth, with Tom Kelly making his debut in tenth and Alan Mania in 11th. So looking at that, what do you think of that grid so far?
You can see that the Nissans have got great pace with Willows and Titani in 1-2. Bit of a struggling performance from the Monster Lexuses, with Kelly, Glazebrook, Orange, and Head got in fourth, and Redmore in third. But it seems to be a little bit of an iffy thing. Orange with a very disappointing qualifying session down in fifth. Cuba doing quite well in sixth, and Grant as well down in seventh, with Manier in 11th for the Sony Hondas. So a bit of a mixed grid, but I can definitely see a Nissan taking the win here. And if I'm going to go between the two, I'd have to say Titani probably. I feel like he'll have the advantage on Willows around this track. Maybe it's the lag. I just see Titani taking it in Austria.
Yeah, I mean, looking at the grid, you know, as mentioned earlier, the Lexuses aren't the strong package around this circuit because of the lack of straight line speed. This is a very, very fast track. But I wouldn't count out Redmore for a potential win. He's got the talent, I think. You know, he might be able to even overcome. I mean, it might be at a disadvantage of Lexus, but they're still very closely grouped, these cars. So he might be able to overcome the disadvantage that he has and use the corners to his advantage, the fast sweeping corners, to maybe try and pick up a win.
Yeah, well, clearly you can see that that clearly one team has clearly got an advantage around this track, and that's the Nissans. But we don't know, of course, because we do have the boost in this, which could mix up the field. But we'll see anyway, because now it is time for the race.
So here we are then, here at the Red Bull Ring. It's James Willows on pole with Matthew Tatani second. My prediction, I think James Willows will take the victory today.
Yeah, I think Matthew Redmore stands a good chance myself. He's looking strong, even though he's got the car disadvantage.
It's got to be for me a Nissan with that pace. I'm going to say Tatani. I think you have the edge on Willows today.
Indeed, we're just waiting for the lights to go out now. There's been a bit of a technical problem. The race hasn't started yet. Waiting for the man with the green flag just to get his flag waving. And we are go! Yep, that is a start. And it's James Willows who gets the good start. And then Tatani, Redmore, they're all piloting to turn one. Redmore tries to have a dive down the inside. Oh, contact already, and it's gone catastrophically wrong. What happened there?
I don't know. It looked like Redmore just went for a dive bomb that didn't work, and he took out James Willows. And now there's three Nissans at the front. It looks like Waze Cuba and Matthew Tatani getting involved. Now James Willows getting involved. I think this is not going to end well.
This could go catastrophically wrong for everybody if it doesn't go right. But luckily, yep, it has. It has. Yeah, that's a crash.
A little bit of lag there from Tatani, but it seems to have gone very nicely. But James Willows holding his lead nicely with Sean Grant seemingly coming up using the slipstream. Will he go for a move down into turn three? He's up the inside. Will he go for it? He definitely is. A little bit of weaving, argy-bargy, and them two are going lovely round there onto the grass of Willows. But Sean Grant takes the lead of this race as Willows now coming back at him.
A little bit
of argy-bargy. Someone's in the grass at the back. That's Matthew Redmore after a decent start. A little bit of contact. Has just fallen off the pace a little bit. I think that's James Head also, who's just overtaken him now as we are going to battle with the pack. But it's Sean Grant and James Willows with an early start. Nobody said a Honda would take the win here, but the Honda is leading this Grand Prix.
It's James Willows versus Sean Grant again.
Yep, it does seem to have the advantage of that Honda, but oh, he's gone well wide. That's completely ruined any chance of the lead for him, and that's almost sealed it for James Willows. But I say that, look at Matt Orange having a cracker on there. He wants his cheeky little look down the inside as the pit crew are coming out. Yep, they are.
I think that's James Ed.
Yep, he is in the pit. So, what's he trying to do here?
Well, it's one of two options. Either one, he's going to be serving his penalty nice and early, get it out of the way, and then push on for the rest of the race. Or he's going to try and take advantage of that boost. As we know from the previous Grand Prix, it's extremely effective. When you pit early, you can use your boost to an advantage, get a massive undercut. I think Head has decided and spoken to Team Boss Glazebrook and decided that this is the best option for this race. As we've got the safety car coming in and parking up ready for whenever an eventuality is needed. It seems as James Head and the team have gone for a strategy, and if you noticed on the last lap going around there, multiple cars going wide around the final two corners. I think that's going to be the corner that catches them out, and I think if there's going to be a safety car today,
he stopped. Sorry to interrupt you there, Casper, but he stopped. I think he just served his 5 second penalty that he was given for this race, so that'll be that done.
That's
and it's going to throw him further behind, but it might make the boost more effective. So sorry, as you were,
I believe now that this race is going to be won or lost depending on the final two corners. I don't know what you guys think, but as we come up to that corner, we're going to see a lot of cars going wide as we've got a replay now of turn one. We're going to have another look at what happened to Redmore and Willows there. If you look at the background as well, there is a Sony Honda that had a bit of a poor start. That's Aluminier. But coming in now is James Willows, goes across very early there on Redmore. Whether or not Redmore could move out of the way, I don't know. We're going to have a look from the Aussie, Matthew Tatani, who gets a little bit of a lag start due to the connection, but we're going to see Redmore gets a cracking start in that Lexus coming now down into turn one. And I think there was a little bit of contact and nothing that could be done there, maybe lag, but Waze Cuba getting a great start there, as you see he's alongside him. But good start and unlucky really.
We've got a look at the view from Waze Cuba now, and we're just waiting, and here we go. He got the best to start. I think he actually avoided the corners. It was actually in front, so he stays behind James Ed. Matt Orange trying to have a look. No, in fact, he actually tried to have a look at the team Lexus as well. Goes for, ooh, that was quite risky, but that paid off.
Yeah, he did. He hit Tatani there, who, as we know, hit Redmore, who then hit Willows. So let's have a look at Tom Kelly here in the bright green Monster Lexus Motorsport Kia. And it is really bright green. And as he doesn't have a number on the car, but that's irrelevant. Let's see how his start went as he comes into turn one. Ooh, just misses Glazebrook there. You get a good view of the carnage from his car, though, as Matt Orange pulls right back in front of him, gets past Redmore, and he has Matthew Redmore himself. As what happened here? Well, he was hit. Well, he had a bit of contact with his comrades there, let's call it, but he seemed to get tapped by them, and that's what caused it to go off. I'm not sure whether that's going to be looked into, but he has some Sean Grant time here.
I think this is how he took the lead.
Yeah, this might be how he took the lead. He was well down.
Whoa!
As that's a bit of a crash. We didn't quite catch what happened, but a lot of cars, someone went flying. For sure, but
I don't think this is how he took the lead, actually. This, from what I'm seeing, this is a few laps later. So Sean Grant has lost the lead somewhere. And there's a little bit of argy-bargy from the rivals. Willows, Orange comes across there. And I think Orange has taken the lead. No, Grant has now retaken the lead from Orange.
It's a replay, Casper. This actually happened ages ago.
I know. But obviously, this must have happened during the pit stop, I'm assuming. And this is a massive crash.
That's a huge off.
That reminds me of Nick Heidfeld from 2002 when he had brake problems and crashed into the Takuma Sato in the side.
Yeah, so all of this was unfolding during the pit stop of James Head. So seemingly James Head has actually avoided a lot of carnage. Just Titani is now pulled away from the pack a little bit. So he's looking a little bit likely to take a possible
pitted,
win.
Actually, John Grant and James Wellers have actually pitted, so...
So there's a bit of pit action going on at the moment. So obviously James Head is being countered by some of the rest of the cars. There's Tom Kelly side by side with Bobby Hunter going into the second from last corner as in comes Matthew Titani reacting to the leaders. The cars have already pitted in James Wellers and Sean Grant as Bobby Hunter takes the provisional lead of this Grand Prix.
He does definitely, and here we go then. He's going to pull into his box. And it's quite a show one. That could be down to lag, but we'll see. And Sean Grant's back in the pit.
Grant is in the pit indeed. He goes ahead of Titani. Now, this is going to be interesting. It's now Honda versus Nissan in the pits. Now, of course, Grant in the later pit box, that is a disadvantage to him because he would have to wait for Titani. And look at that. Glazebrook comes through and Titani does go through, so he's lost out.
I think Glazebrook actually had a glitch when he came into the pits because I think this is the reason why Sean's back in the pits because... You have to be at a certain point to get into the pits because there's like a cone where you have to follow, and if you go over that, the game will go to you and you'll go straight through the pits. So I think that's what happened to Sean, and that's why he came back into the pits. So there's two Nissans fighting.
Yep, Willows and Titani. That's Bobby Hunter, not Titani. The cars look similar, but obviously not. So Willows now are in a crack at Hunter. Let's see if they can do it. Coming into Powerhorse here. Trying to get a bit more ground on him, but he can't, but he goes off. Hunter has gone off. Well, it might be for a while because he's back ahead now. So he is, and they're coming up to a bright green Monza Lexus. There is the other Nissan right behind them as well. That is Titani. That's where it's Cuba. There's four Nissans now, I keep forgetting.
I think Cuba actually let these two through, to be honest.
Yeah, it could be a lap down. To be a lap down after this early in the race wouldn't be a good thing. But he might just let
them
through.
Mistake.
Yep, Honda has messed up. He's gone into the pits. It's ghosted him. He's going to go straight through. No chance of a pit stop. It just goes to show pit entry really is crucial, isn't it, Casper?
I think people are forgetting that you have to break into the pit lane. I think many of these guys have played the current Formula 1 games and expect the game to automatically break for you. But in this game, you have to break very, very early to go into the pits. And this is a massive issue. Hence, Sean Grant has received a punishment for his mistake. And I think people are going to learn after this first pit stop. So during the second run of pit stops, I think you're going to be seeing guys go a lot more slowly, and put the brakes down and try to be a little bit more clean. And you can see what the effects have had. Sean Grant has had the pit twice now, which has taken him from a front-running position to actually dropping off quite significantly in the pace. As you look on the Monster Lexus there with Redmore trying to make up for his earlier incident on lap one, as you can see. Wade Cuba going wide there, almost hitting the Monster Lexus Motorsport of James Head, but everything keeping it clean. Wade Cuba maybe needs to calm down a little bit because he does seem to exceed the track limits a few times. But overall, it's been a good race, and I think Willows is definitely exceeding in this race so far, with James Head in second, so he's made the strategy work. If he wouldn't have had that 5-second penalty, who knows, he could be a long way ahead.
Yeah, exactly. And like I mentioned last week, I think people are trying to leave their strategies late because we've got boost in this, and I think people are trying to keep it late because although they'll end up behind them, they'll have more speed to catch them up and overtake them. So that's why people are trying to keep their strategies a little bit later. And because of the boost, Head is now on the back of Willows.
He is now. We are approaching the 1/4 distance marker in this race. There is still a lot of race to go, but it just seems to have flown by actually. Seven laps. And that's a bit of fishtailing going up for James Head there. That's going to ruin his chance. He'll have to try and make a fight back for the lead now.
Absolutely now. And he's lucky he hasn't lost any positions, but I wouldn't be surprised if someone actually overtakes him right now because of how slow of a rejoin he's tried to get back on the track. And there is someone actually catching up to him. It's one of the Lexuses. I believe that might be Matthew Orange. In fact, there was side-by-side action between the Nissan and the Honda.
absolutely no team orders will be going on there, I think. Well, not yet at least, but you know, we'll be seeing how that goes, hopefully at some point in the future, as we look at current race leader James Willows as he continues his charge into the, well, the unknown and the depths of the lead of this race.
Definitely, he must have had a bit of a breathing space after what happened to James Head. And I don't know if Matthew Redmore is, not Redmore, Orange is actually, we've got too many Matthews in this race is what I'm trying to say.
Too many Matthews and not enough Erics.
One thing you have to take into consideration with when James Head did have his incident, if you look carefully on the tyres, there was a long, thick layer of dirt. This is one of the major things, and they're lucky here at the Red Bull Ring that the track is quite non-corner orientated, because these tyres are very, very delicate. They're like priceless jewellery or really elegantly made clay models. If you crack them or chip them, their value goes down completely. And in this race, you will see that significantly, because tyres are very valuable round here. You don't seem to know it, but the tyres will wear out very quickly, as it's softs and mediums here at the Red Bull Ring. You're going to see a lot of tyre grip lost very early on. So many guys will start with the softs and go on to the mediums and then stay on the mediums because they last a lot longer than the other tyres on option.
Yeah, it would seem that is the case. You need to preserve your tyres as you would a workman's tools. You need to keep them in good condition, otherwise they are useless.
Exactly, they have to use both compounds, and with a second stop they can choose whatever they want. But I think, like what Casper just said, the advice is you ditch the soft tyres, get onto the mediums and then get back on the softs, and that's your strategy done.
I just want to mention there quickly, James Head has come in already for his second stop, and we're only on lap 8. As you said previously, we're only at the quarter mark, so James Head is definitely playing a risky strategy here. His tyres will be dead at the end of the race, and he's probably hoping there'll be a safety car of some sorts, and he'll get to put on some fresh rubber. But it's a very interesting strategy here from Head, whether there was a conversation between the teams, but I think it's very risky for him to be pitting so early for fresh tyres, but it's his choice, and he's going to try and play out till the end of the race.
Yeah, we'll just have to see how that goes. We'll have to see how whether he can hold his tyres for long enough. They will be screaming at the end of this race just to stop, but of course that won't happen. It's an interesting strategy, something that, well, no one else seems to be trying. But we've got another mistake here. That is Matthew Tatani, who has screwed up massively on the pit entry again, and now he's going to suffer the same fate as all those before him in having to go straight through the pits with no stop, and that is going to hurt him.
Sean Grant's actually back in the pits, I've just noticed.
Yep, he's come back in as well.
I'm a little bit surprised as well that Sean Grant and even Tatani there was planning on pitting. Why are these guys pitting so early? It seems like James Head is dictating what everyone else is doing. As you can hear the screech of that Honda, it sounds like a child screaming for mercy. That is a horrible sound in my opinion. But why are these guys pitting so early when they know that their tyres are going to die off? I think many of them are expecting a safety car, but so far there hasn't been many major incidents apart from Redmore, of course, and that seems to be it. So there's a lot of risky stuff going, and if I'm honest, at the moment it seems that James Willows is playing this race perfectly. He's pitted once and reacted, and there seems to be absolutely no one behind him for at least 7 or 8 seconds, and he's doing a great job in that Nissan. It suits the track, and it's definitely a great showing from Willows at the moment.
Well, it's like I mentioned, it's because the cars have got boost, they're trying to pit early to get the boost out when they're coming out the pits and then try and catch up to their opponent.
As you just said there, they are sacrificing tyre grip for boost. Whether that's a good strategy or not, we will find out later on in the race. But at the moment, Willows is cruising very Lewis Hamilton and Nico Rosberg-esque. And this Nissan is the Mercedes of GT500. There is a car slowly closing down on them behind, and that is Matthew Orange, his rival. So at the moment, the Lexus in this Matthew Orange, as he goes a little bit wide there, is outshining what he should be doing. As you can see, a little bit of a pack of Redmore, Cuba, and Head slowly close down, and at the moment Willows is easily going to look at his a possible win today, with Orange trying to get some scrap points in second. But obviously the guy's going for different strategies as Cuba comes down with that overpowered Nissan engine. That car is just devilish in a straight line, as Redmore once again goes dramatically wide and gets on the grass and loses control. Whether it was a handbrake turn, we don't know, but he's made a dramatic mistake once again. Redmore just showing he's a great qualifier, but racer, maybe he's not the best.
It is a problem getting on the grass with these cars because they have so much downforce, and then going on the grass, that affects it in the sense that, well, you've got 500 horsepower to the back wheels and nearly 600 horsepower to the back wheels. You know, you can't really control it that easy. It's closer to 500 than it is 600, but, you know, it's very hard to keep control of that much power on a grass and then you lose downforce. It's just almost a recipe for disaster.
Exactly. And, again!
Again, he goes off and loses the grip.
I wouldn't be surprised if the stewards are considering warning Redmore, because at the moment, he's not only endangering himself, he's also endangering the rest of the drivers there. He's almost taken Sean Gran out. You notice he was in a battle as he comes in the pits now with Bobby Hunter. And he was
safety
in a battle.
Safety car has been
deployed. So something has happened. We don't know where. We'll find out in a minute, as Matthew Orange has pitted perfectly. So has Redmore. And I believe that was Bobby Hunter there. James Willows also pitted. So the guys have reacted to the safety car. Luckily for Willows, he got in there just before it was deployed. So things are going off. We'll hopefully get a replay very shortly. So now, all of them guys who pitted early, the James Heads, the Sean Grant, they're getting their dreams come true as the safety car has been deployed here on lap 11.
It has, and this is the first time this season we've seen this, so it's going to be interesting to see how the procedure goes. Now let's have a look at this replay here. This could be why, yeah, Bobby Hunter goes round, hits the wall, and makes a spin, and then he actually pulls back onto the track, but I'm not entirely sure that could have caused it, unless he has a collision, and that was close to Sean Grant there. So that could have been the cause for it, I'm not sure, but it's entirely plausible. It's all speculation, really, as we see that Nissan being driven, of course, by Michael Moran there in the safety car. It should be pointed out, just for he's doing some nice backing of the field up there, mind.
Yeah, I'm gonna take a pot in the dark. Sorry, there. I'm just gonna have a little pot in the dark there. I think that there was a bit of debris that fell off the car from that incident, and I think the stewards wanted to get it cleared up because that corner is dangerous on its own. And I think that only due to safety, I think they want to clear up the debris, and maybe the stewards want a little bit more racing to go on. As the safety car is in this lap, I'm gonna hand it over to my colleagues for the safety car in lap.
Yeah, we are gonna get. We're gonna get back. From the restart time is imminent here at the Red Bull Ring behind the safety car. The first time this season, the field have closed right back up, and we find Whis Cuba in the lead at the start. What a chance for him! So here we go then, at the start. Well, okay, we've got a pitter already, but here we go then. Cuba at the start, we should be getting green flag imminently, and they are go, I think. So Cuba now having to fly down the main straight under attack from everyone as they pile into turn one again. Is this going to end in disaster? We'll find out as we got a car jumping him up. No, that's gone wrong.
It has. Tom Kelly trying to be a little bit greedy with overtaking. He probably was overexcited that the lead was right in front of him, and that hasn't ended well. Now it's three abreast going up to the Remus curve.
Yep, it is. Now, that hasn't gone well for Cuba, but let's see now. Sean Grant's managed to benefit. He's gone for the lead into the curve, and he goes round the outside of everyone. Makes it look significantly easier than it is.
Exactly, and now Matthew Titani has obviously lost out quite a lot, and now it's three abreast down there. And now, again, there's too many three abreast going on down through a lot of corners, and now Willows is now in the lead. Oh, contact there.
Oh, yep, everyone's going off. Titani's having to do. That could just be his connection, though, as we've said many times so far. As Glazebrook now there as well. Someone's gone off. Everyone's going off. Dust everywhere. Things are getting a little bit rowdy here as we are about a minute away from the 20-minute mark of this quite enthralling race here in Austria. So let's have a look at how things are shaping up then. We see, well, it's still going how it was before in that sense, but it's still racing. But as we look at James Willows, everything's gone black. Technical difficulties, and well, what can you say, really?
Well, from what I could see there, when everyone saw the safety car and saw the opportunity to be first, I think a car has just gone off in the background there, I'm not sure. But everyone just saw the opportunity to go first, and I think everyone got a little bit too greedy. I think that the flashing lights of victory got into Tom Kelly's head, and he made a mistake, because once again, it's Grant versus Willows up top. repeat of Monza, as you can see Orange is making his way through, but everyone seemed to see the chance of a victory there and got a little bit too aggressive, and everyone just wants to win this race, it seems, when in reality I think it's down to Grant or Willows at this point, who are just really doing a great job, as the Lexuses don't have the straight line speed, as Hunter's now up in third as they're going side by side. This is the sort of battle we want to see. Two aggressive drivers who both want victory, who both want to succeed in this league, going down into turn three. Grant taking the inside line as he undercut for Willows. He does that beautifully and holds first position, as it's Orange and Kibblewhite battling behind him with Hunter, as we get a replay now on board with Glazebrook as he goes into the second to last corner. Cuba just cuts in front of Kibblewhite and just absolutely wipes them out. Tom Kelly probably disappointed there as he gets on the grass, as I said earlier, maybe it's debris, maybe it's oil, and that is a very dangerous corner. You get on the grass, you are going to spin, and there, as I said it, Orange goes wide and spins, and in the background Glazebrook loses it, and so does Titani. As I said, this track is a devilish place for losing your rear end.
That was quite a big crash from Glazebrook there. Now, whether that's safety car worthy, I'm not sure. He seemed to get it out of the way of everyone, but we'll just have to see. But there are a lot of spins and crashes in that corner. And turn one, very difficult to master it. Well, it seems there's been quite a few incidents there. As we got another one there, as Wastecuber gets a tiny bit of oversteer going on, loses some slight time there. But looking at it here, it's James Willows again, but he's under threat from Hunter this time.
He is, definitely. And Willows now, He's under threat. Oh no, Robert Hunter has gone off actually.
Yes, that can't be beneficial at all.
I'm stuttering over myself there.
It's only going to benefit James Willows here. He's going to get his lead back.
Clouds are drawing.
Oh, we have clouds indeed. So, this is an interesting conversation point. Rain or no rain?
That's definitely going to be the question. As you have noticed, if you might have noticed there, Matthew Orange did lose the rear end there. I'm noticing it seems to be a fact now with the Lexuses that they have seemingly, in their rear tyres, they have a lot of wheel spin, as Willows nips the grass there. There's a lot of wheel spin in the rear tyres with the Lexuses, which I think could be a massive issue for them, because they seem to, out of all the cars, lose the rear end the most. Maybe there's too much power at the rears. We don't know, of course, at this point, as I think that's Michael Moron exiting the pits, whether he's coming for fresh tyres. I'm a little bit worried it might be a safety car there, just with the clouds drawing.
No, it's just the way how the game works, Casper.
There we go then. I don't want another safety car. This racing is enthralling at the moment, as there seems to be Orange hogging the slipstream as Grant goes around the outside. Orange follows him through, giving him a bit of a bump there, as Orange now taking the outside. Willows is losing out dramatically. Three abreast going into turn two now, as Willows is cut across by, I think that's Sean Grant it was, and Hunter and Redmore alike both lose the rear end there. Great battling here as Kibblewhite tries to take advantage of Willows losing out there. The number 10 car defending as number 99 Pitmat comes through. The unnamed yellow Sean Grant, as I think a little battle there between Willows and Matthew Orange taking full advantage, and he takes the lead for probably a very short time, as we've in two corners time. I dare say Grant will get the slipstream and the overpowered
Someone's
speed
gone off in the background
of the Honda. Oh yes, yeah. They have. It's just so much going on. You cannot seem to just, it's just so much going on in this race at the moment, as you can see Grant there right behind Matthew Orange, and whether or not it stays like this, we're going to find out.
Lots of havoc going on now, isn't there?
Yeah, Redmore even made that same mistake he did a few laps ago. Now side-by-side action is Sean Grant and Matthew Orange. Clearly, these two are not stopping fighting. It's pretty much one team being represented for each other, basically, on who will win.
Oh dear, that's a bit of an oversteer moment from Hunter, as we keep saying, that last corner, that infernal last corner, so hard to get right, so easy to get wrong. It causes havoc when we go around it, and now we've got more problems there. There's Wastecuber having to do, and it's turn one and turn, the last turn again, as I keep saying, the difficult ones here that have caused the incidents and caused the problems as the safety cars move from the decision. And Hunter
Hunter.
lordy, oh wow, that has not gone well for him at all, but he somehow managed to keep it going without hitting anyone else.
If there is an award for save of the day, then that will definitely go to Hunter. So I'm just going to add quickly there, as obviously Redmore spins. Lucky no one else gets caught in it. We do have our first retirement of the race. Alan Menier of the Sony Honda Racing has retired from the Grand Prix, leaving Redmore to be the dead last driver at the moment. So only one Honda left in this Grand Prix.
Safety car.
And there is
a
safety car.
We have it out again. A second safety car of the race. Now I'm going to take a very safe bet here and say that was because of the whole Bobby Hunter spins causes havoc at the back of the grid catastrophe, but Matthew Redmore might just be able to get out of the wooden spoon position if other people pit here. But, you know, he's there for now as there's no overtaking in safety car conditions. So we're waiting for the safety car. They're going to pick up the race leader, of course, but let's see who pits. I'm expecting a lot of people. There's a bit more off-track action happens here as well. Oh, actually, no one as well. We have one person coming to the pits, and that's a nice little drift there from the Monster Lexus Motorsport there. Car couldn't pick up who it was. And that's a lot of tyre smoke as we see one Monster Lexus going to the pits. There's so much camera action and so many black screens. We can't make out what's going on.
It's Austrian television.
Well, it's always the television, isn't it? You always say that. It was Japanese television last time. As Redmore gets into the pits, decides not to go out of the wooden spoon position, trying to get a fresh set of tyres, maybe a bit more fuel in there as well. Wise choice, because he wouldn't have gained anything, maybe, from, well, not pitting. And, well, James Ed's gone through the pits. Has he pitted? Has he just overshot it? I'm not sure. But he says he's position 9 when he's, well, it was Redmore that was position 9 and he's been passed now, so...
Yeah, exactly. Now, some of the drivers who don't have numbers, we do know their numbers. I think it's just they can't be, you know, they haven't had a chance to put it on the car yet. So, Sean Grant hasn't got a number, but he's actually number 23. Tom Kelly's number 7, and James Head's actually number 47. So, some of the drivers don't have numbers, but we can work it out ourselves.
I think it was just a sticker shortage, to be honest with you. So, here we go then.
A pay cut.
A pay cut, sticker shortage, call it what you like, but... We have the cars behind the pace car, not coming in this lap, it seems. Going to stay out for one more while everyone else gets behind it. So we are going to be on lap 18 under safety car conditions as we are starting to approach the 3-quarter mark. We're not there yet, but we're about a couple of minutes away from it. As well, the clouds seem to be lightening up, actually, which is a bit of a shame because rain would have really helped the race. Not like it needs any more excitement, but it does seem to be lightening up a bit now.
All of the cars now are backing up, of course. We've got Matthew Owings leading from Sean Grant, who seems to always be there. So far, I've said, if you would have told me early on in the race, I would have said James Willows would definitely take the end of this take this race to the end. But these safety cars have definitely put a spanner in the works with this Grand Prix. Orange is leading at the moment, but with the fresh tyres that Redmore and James Head have now, you know, it could see them two come through the pack, and I don't know whether or not anyone else will pit now, whether there'll be any more pit stops, but so far I have to say the most dangerous corners we've seen have to be the corner we're coming up to right now, which is Remus. And that's a very dangerous corner, as you've seen multiple times. Hunter's gone off and Redmore's gone off, and it's actually caused this safety car. Do you think the drivers are being a little bit optimistic as Kibble overtakes someone under the safety car there? Whether that'll be under investigation, we'll have to find out. But do you think the drivers are being a little bit too optimistic with braking? I mean, there seems to be that wherever they think they can get a move, they will do. Like, in most racing, you will see guys go for the move overtake round the straights and use the slipstream, but these guys just seem to think that they can overtake at any corner.
It's not like this is NASCAR, is it? You know, but they do seem to be quite optimistic. I think some of them need to learn just to back off a bit when things aren't going their way, you know.
Just, I think some of them need to learn a lesson, basically.
We've seen that in IF3C, you know, with the likes of Joshua Anderson, where he backs off where he knows he can't get it, and when he sees a chance, dies for it. I think
that's a tip.
Thanks very much for pointing that out. But I think, you know, they need to take some of those lessons, to be honest, you know. Just maybe back off a bit if things aren't going to go your way. As well, we saw Josh Anderson in I3 say he was going to take the championship before he had to retire. So, you know, maybe that sort of driving style would benefit the others as well. The safety car pulls ahead. Matt Orange backing the field up as he's entitled to do. But there's contact everywhere. He slowed them down too much. Tried too much to be Jensen Button when he's not. And that has caused havoc. But luckily, it seems to have evened out somewhat. Hopefully, no more sudden stop starts. He's roaring ahead now, trying not to back them up anymore or trying to cause confusion. I don't know what he's doing, but it's going to be a restart either way as we come around to the last corner, and we're going to go again one more time as we're 3/4 away through the race, and he's given up the lead already. It's Sean Grant. He's through, and that's catastrophe for him.
There, it's not been the best start for Matthew Orange, as you see Hunter taking advantage there, as Glazebrook and Willows going side by side. Orange has made a monumental mistake there. That is not what you want to be doing. When you've got the lead, you get such a good start and you pull away just minorly. All you have to do is take the lead into the first corner, and then you will be okay. But Orange has made a massive mistake as Willows blitzes through the middle of Orange, and Hunter there cuts in front, and I believe now he's gonna, I think he might be ahead of Grant. No, but Grant has held the lead. It's a great restart for Willows. As I said, I thought he would take the win now as he's side by side with Sean Grant. It's gonna be tight. These two have done this corner multiple times side by side, and Grant takes the lead again as Bobby Hunter hits his teammates. Clearly no team orders going on there as Red Gems is pushed off wide as well, and Bobby Hunter seems to have something in for James Willows at the moment. It always seems to be him, and there's a green Lexus. I believe that is Tom Kelly, who's just gone off wide dramatically. It is the number 7 car has made a huge error. Remember or not, he had contact. Maybe we'll get a replay to have a look very shortly, but James Willows and Bobby Hunter, it always seems to be them two as teammates that seem to be making contact.
Yep, it does seem to be those two. Maybe there's a bit of a cross-seller rivalry going on here. Maybe they just don't like each other. But as we see another monster go off, Titani goes off, and oh my god, Gideon, that's a massive off from Oliver Glazebrook. And well, he seems to have benefited from that. I'm not sure whether the stewards are going to... I think they should definitely, in the least, take a look, should the stewards, even if they don't decide to do anything, because that was one of the maddest things I've ever seen.
I think the flashing lights have got to him once again. This race now, the issue with this race is, from last to first, it's literally 5 seconds, and everyone seems to think they can get the win as we're on board now. We're not on board, we're in the third person cam of Waze Cuba, who has pitted for fresh soft tyres, I'm hearing he has gone on to. So Waze Cuba, I believe, for the last 10 minutes is going to be pushing all out with them soft tyres, whether he's expecting another pit. He's definitely going to. He's going to have to use that boost to full advantage now, as we cannot even see the cars now as we're coming on board with, I believe this is going to be a Monster Lexus of Redmore, as he's battling through the pack. As Grant is holding on to the lead at the moment, as once again there is rain on the track. I don't know whether it'll be massively effective, but it will definitely cause a few issues as we're seeing one of them right now. Robert Patrick Hunter has made a huge error once again, trying to beat his teammate James Willows, and maybe immaturity, brand new to the game, of course, and maybe he just doesn't understand what a braking zone is.
Perhaps he doesn't, we don't know. I hope he does, though, to get his license. You know, he'd have to do that. But yeah, there is drizzle on the track. Will it affect things? Will there be standing water? It's always interesting when the rain comes into play, as it did so late in the race at Monza. So, and we know where that went, didn't we? We saw the race get so much more interesting than that. But the thing is, we've got 7 minutes to go. Could we see the intermediate tyres come out?
It would be a surprise if they did, but at the moment we're on board with Tom Kelly, and at the moment there's three guys at the front with one tag along at the moment. It is Grant, Willows or Orange, who looks likely to take this race win, with at the moment the tag along being Glazebrook. I'm doubtful that's going to last for very long, as these guys seem to be nowhere near the skill level of Grant, Orange and Willows, and I definitely think one of them's going to take it. Obviously, the Nissan seems to be very good around this track, so I'm going to say Willows. Titani, my guess, has just not performed for me today. Maybe it's the lag, but he's not been doing the business as you would expect from that Nissan as well. You'd also see the complete contrast of Waze Cuba and Willows. It just shows that I think Willows has got easily 1.5 seconds on his teammates at the moment, just showing he's got some good skill as the number 10 driver is at the moment in third position, as Glazebrook, surprisingly, has actually got himself up into second. I'm not expecting that. He goes wide, and here goes Willows up in the inside, side by side, a little bit of argy-bargy, and whether Willows got the move, we're not sure. His head has actually gone off wide there, so maybe the drizzle was starting to affect the drivers.
It might be
done. Yeah, we saw Tom Kelly come in. Whether that's for intermediates or not, we didn't see. Interesting if it is, though, because it could pay off, but we didn't get the chance to look at the tyre treads, see if there was any, you know, grooves in them or not. But we'll see as time progresses, as there are 5 minutes or so left to go in this race. And well, I think that's ample time with the amount of laps here for some standing water to get on the track. It does look like the track's getting shiny, I must say. As we look at the drivers as they pile into this turn. Once more, as we do come up to the 5 minute mark now. Three going in the same corners once. We've seen that so many times this race, and there's tyre smoke everywhere.
you listened very carefully there, you could hear the brakes and the tyres just screaming. It's almost deafly the sound that these cars are having to make to slow down so dramatically. The brakes, of course, aren't the best in these cars. They're good enough, but they aren't the best in the world. But you can see now it is a Nissan from two Monster Lexus Motorsports, and then another two Nissans followed by the Honda that are going into these next few corners. Whether or not it will be a Lexus, a Honda, or a Nissan, of course, winning this Grand Prix, we're going to have to find out in the next few laps, as Orange is battling once again with Willows. Seems to be a little bit of a rivalry going on between Willows and Orange. Obviously, previous league history, as you mentioned earlier, the IF3C and various Formula 1 leagues and GT6 leagues that they partake in, they seem to always be there. And Sean Grant is a new name to the list of drivers who seem to be interested and intriguingly involved in this battle. As Glazerick's on the grass, so is Tatali. Last time this happened, this didn't end very well, and he's held it nicely. Whether he went off the accelerator there just to keep the wheel spin down to a minimum, he's lost out though dramatically from second all the way down to, I believe, that sixth.
Yeah, I think that is the case as well, as Glazewood now wants to try and get back up the field after he's been off the track down at the last corner.
He wants to do that, indeed he does. His time's running out for him to do it. Grant gets a nice little shove up the inside there. It gets on the back of Willows now, trying to get the lead that he wants so desperately back as well. Well, James Willows, we've seen this before though, he's not going to give up easy, as Grant's going to have to make this work for him, not Willows having to make it work for him. And yep, Grant does what he needs to, get himself through, back into the lead.
I'm not sure whether there's a failure going on with Willows, as his front lights are going off there, whether or not he's just informing someone he's there. It's kind of irritating to see, as we've got the beautiful scenery of the Austrian guest. Getting my continents a little bit wrong there, getting my nations a little bit dodgy. It's being the Austrian, that's the right nation, the Austrian scenery, lovely. Whether or not the graphics could be improved, that's a different question. Is Grant on the grass there? Definitely the wet weather is considerably making issues as Grant and Glazebrook make contact. He's on the the dodgy tarmac there, and Grant holds the lead. It's just a lovely camera angle swooping as we see Willows leading this race once again from Grant, and it's Redmore or Orange, depending, I'm unsure. But it always seems to be Willows and Grant in these races, and Orange just behind. Whether he was in a better car, he could exceed a lot more. We'll have to find out.
Orange is now getting into this scrap for the lead now.
Yep, as they pile into the very, very difficult Brimley's curve once again. But luckily, no one's incidents this time.
Exactly.
They managed to keep it nice and clean around that turn this time. Will the same be said for this corner? Will the corner be the same this time around this time as we've got Grant? Oh, look at this, three wide in the same corner. Oh, very quick, Grant in the middle, trying to keep his lead, which he does successfully until James Willows decides to take it back from him.
Oh, Hunter.
Hunter is sideways and in the gravel he goes. That is not what you want to be doing. With only, I believe, there's only two laps remaining. You do not want to be going off wide. Sadly, I have to say, I think Bobby Hunter's chances of a race victory are now over. It's seemingly going to be between the guys you see now, from Glazebrook to Willows. One of these guys will leave here with the big golden cup, the GT500 Round 2 trophy that they will hold preciously to their hearts. And who are we guys? I'm going to ask you two. Who are you putting your money on as we come into the penultimate lap?
I'm still sticking with James Willows.
It's too close for me now. We've got a minute to go of this race. As you see there, I was about to say we're coming into the closing stages, but Casper did my job for us there. Thank you very much. but yeah, one more minute of this race to go. I think the lap times are just over a minute, in fact. So I think if something goes wrong, we could be on the final lap here. Lap 25. Maybe Sean Grant can. Oh, he's lost it. That's a catastrophe for the Ulsterman. He was so close, yet now he is so far away. Interestingly, the safety car was parked on the curb that time. I don't know whether he just got distracted or not. I'm not sure. But James Willows could be a step close at the victory here.
Oh, someone else has gone off. I think that was Redmore.
That was Redmore. He's off now. So it's Willows from Tatani. I'm going to hand
I think there may be team orders, because Willows Nissan Grand Prix have always said whoever's ahead on the last lap is the winner. So I don't know whether Tatani has got that call in his head or he's
forgotten. It is the final lap. It is the final lap, as I suspected. So, is there going to be any team orders here?
Tatani's ignoring it. He's going for it.
Oh, it's a brave Aussie. He's going into the last two turns, into the final second to last turn. He's going for it.
He's lost the
last turn. He's lost it. Oh, catastrophe here. I don't know who it's going to be. It's going to be close. Tatani's not in it anymore, but as we cross the line, I think it's going to be James Head. He has by a fraction. Oh!
So, as I said earlier, it would be one of them three drivers, and it became down to a photo finish. Matthew Orange in the very poor, let's be frank, Lexus car, has got himself a race victory against the odds. Great performance from Matthew Orange. Disappointing for Willows, but it's nothing to be disappointed about. A great showing there from the guys and a great win for Orange.
Indeed, he managed to get himself. Please don't talk over me, but yeah. You see, that was interesting because he won in the car, which we said was at a disadvantage.
Absolutely. So, after an amazing race here at the Red Bull Ring, here is the final results. Orange won the race only just from James Willows in second place. James Head actually finished in third with Sean Grant fourth. Matthew Tatani was fifth with Ollie Glazebrook sixth. Matthew Redmore seventh with Robert Hunter eighth. Tom Kelly was ninth. And Cuba actually retired from the race later on along with Munoz. But he still gets the point as he was classified in the top 10. In the Drivers' Championship, James Willows still leads. But his nearest rival now, Matt Orange, is only 6 points behind. Sean Grant is dropped down to third, with James Head fourth, Ollie Glazebrook fifth, Alan Munir is sixth, and Matthew Tatani seventh. He's moved up to seventh, in fact, after his disqualification from Monza 80s. Matthew Redmore is eighth, with Robert Hunter ninth, Daniel Roberts tenth, Thomas Kelly 11th, and Wace Cuba in 12th. In the Manufacturers Championship, Monster Lexus Motorsport can be happy because they now are in the lead in the Manufacturers, with Willows Nissan Grand Prix in second, and Sony Honda Racing, who were the leaders coming into this event, have dropped from first to last. So, they are the results, so let's head back to the studio to reveal some incidents. So, that was absolute cracking race, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was fantastic. And a close finish at the end, as we've become accustomed to seeing in World Super GT 500, happened as well. But in the end, it was Matt Orange who took, well, arguably the closest win I've ever seen in racing. And, well, it's going to be one of the close ones this season, isn't it?
Yeah, it was. Now, Casper, this was your first time commentating over this. What did you make of it?
I thought it was an absolutely cracking Grand Prix. Not only the race in general, but the finish just summed up the GT500 in just like a millisecond. It summed it up. Three guys all crossing the line within a thousandth of each other. Just shows how tight this league really is. And Matthew Orange, against the odds, has taken his first win of the season. It's very similar to what we had in Monza, but it's a lot closer. And congratulations to Orange. I'm very disappointed for Willows, though, who was pretty much, I would have to say, dominant throughout the entire race, and sadly he lost out because of his teammate Matthew Tatani.
Yeah, I'm wondering if the Willows Nissan Grand Prix board are going to have a word with him. Well, let's finish on a high note, shall we, with some racing incidents. Let's see who's going to get a slap on the wrist. So, who is it? Well, Matthew Tatani.
Yes, it is Matthew Tatani. He just said there that maybe Willows Nissan GP are going to be having a word with him. I am the bearer of bad news in this instance, in that they're never going to get the chance because the stewards, I'm just going to come out and say it, he's been taken out of the league because of his problems that he's tied with his lag incidents. The stewards have ruled that it's become too much for him, too much that he's a hazard to the other drivers, and they have, unfortunately, had to remove him from the series.
That is very sad news. Now, Willows Nissan Grand Prix are going to have to look for a new driver. But if they can't, well, they're screwed.
Well, in championship hopes, title hopes, definitely. Drivers individually, maybe not so, but the teams will take a big hit if they can't get a new guy.
Casper, what do you make of this?
It's disappointing, not only for him, but for the team. But in the long run, it's a little bit unfair on the other drivers. You know, the statement released by the stewards clearly said that it was a risk to the other drivers and that it's not fair on everyone else. You've got to look at it. There was three people who were willing to leave this league because of his lag issues. And in the long run, the stewards have to say, well, we're going to sacrifice one guy being in the league for the sake of three others being able to race. It's sad for Titani, but I dare say him and the team will have to get over it. Whether the lag issues do improve in the future, hopefully he can rejoin the league. He's a good driver and he's a great guy, a very nice guy, but it just seems to be the continental difference has forced him to no longer be in GT500.
It is very sad. Well, we'll have to see who Willow's higher up in the next race, because the next race is at the Nürburgring, the Grand Prix track. It is a fantastic venue. Had to be shortened because the Nordschleife was dangerous, but overall it should provide some good action. Let's hope we had some good action like we had today. But until now, we have to leave the Red Bull Ring and end this broadcast. So from me,
and also me,
it's goodbye, and we'll see you at the Nürburgring. Take care.
I'll tell you all my secrets. We're encouraged like a second skin. The kids are all tired.